Very good morning, students. Welcome back to your literature class. The previous day we have started with the chapter The Word Wizard, and we are going to continue the same story today. So get ready fast with your book. Ready? Is everyone ready? Okay. Now, in the last class, we have seen that Mr. and Mrs. Delmonico were having a discussion of what pets could they gift their twins. And the word wizard was listening to them. Okay. We are going to continue from page 118. Right? What about a kitten? Asked Mrs. Delmonico, crunching toast. Kittens are pretty. Cats have 9 lives, you know. Mrs. Delmonico then next suggested, what about kittens? They have 9 lives. So, and theirs are pretty. True, true, answered Mr. Delmonico, sipping his hot coffee. But they have their disadvantages. You know how any music on the violin brings on my hay fever. Her husband said, yeah, they are pretty, but any music on violin brings me hay fever. Hay fever means fever plus allergy. But dear, what does a violin have to do with a kitten for the twins? His wife said, but what will you do with the violin and the kittens together? Don't you remember, hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle? Mr. Delmonico cried. Mr. Delmonico said, don't you remember, hey diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle? But dear Delmonico, that was only one cat, his wife protested. His wife said, that was only one cat who could play violin, not all the cats can. If one can play the fiddle, they all can, Mr. Delmonico declared. But her husband said, if one cat can, then everyone can. I don't fancy taking the risk. Besides, get all over the place, cats. How about something more unusual? Mr. Delmonico said, I don't want to take any risk. And moreover, the cats always sits everywhere. So let's go for something else, something more unusual. What about a lion then? Mrs. Delmonico asked. Lions are very beautiful and very brave. There is a well-known saying, as bold as a lion. Mrs. Delmonico said, then can we have lions? They are very brave and as well as beautiful. Oh, my dear, Mr. Delmonico exclaimed, laughing. The real saying is, bold as a lion. Mr. Delmonico still did not agree. Lions are only beautiful to begin with. On their second birthdays, they suddenly go bald and the chairs and carpets are covered in lion hair. Mr. Delmonico says lions are very beautiful in the beginning, but just after their first birthday, that means on the second birthday, they go totally bald. Bald means their hairs, no hairs are there on the head. All the hairs of the lion's skin you will see on the carpets and chairs. Mrs. Delmonico sipped a cup of tea in a disappointed fashion. I would hate that, she said. Perhaps we'd better get them a pet next year. Mrs. Delmonico now was not tired and said, we'll have to bring them a pet. Goodness me, what a good idea, cried Mr. Delmonico. You are very wise, my dear. Leave the twins' birthday presents to me. Mr. Delmonico said, do one thing. Leave their gifts upon me. Let me decide their gifts. Well, thought the wizard, here is a man who uses words for the purpose of confuscation. Confuscation means confusion. Here is a man who chops words and changes meanings. A word wizard can't stand for that. I will teach him a lesson. Let me see now what plan can I come up with. The wizard thought that he is a man who changes words and its meanings. He is a man who creates confusion, and I cannot stand here and listen everything. So now let me think something else. The weasel tossed an idea into the air. It burst off like a mosquito over the lawn straight to Mr. Delmonico and stung him on the nose. The wizard put an idea and that went up to Mr. Delmonico. Mr. Delmonico bought his twins, Sarah and Francis, presents beginning with C, like cameras and crayons, clarinets and comics, and a great big fire engine red Christmas cracker. It had a black label on it saying, "Beware Monster Cracker." Now, Mr. Delmonico called his children or his twins and handed them a present which began with C, and it was like cameras and crayons, clarinets and comics, and fire engine with Christmas cracker. It's a toy making sounds. It had a black label on it saying "Beware Monster Cracker," and it was labeled "Beware, Be Careful Monster Cracker." I bought it at the Wizard's Bargain Store Monster Sale. Mr. Delmonico said, "I can't wait to see what is inside it." Mr. Delmonico said that he bought the gift from Wizard's Bargain Store Monster Sale and he cannot wait to see what was inside it. Francis took one end and Sarah took the other. They pulled and then suddenly the cracker burst with a snap and a roar like a cannon let off in a cave. The room filled with smoke and the smell of gunpowder. Now, the gift was totally packed. From one end, Sarah pulled and from the other, Francis pulled. And they pulled and suddenly it got burst and the whole room was full of gunpowder smell and smoke. But when the smoke cleared away, there sitting in the middle of the floor was a monster. And when the smoke was cleared, they saw on the middle of the floor a monster was sitting. It had 8 legs and carried a violin tucked under its chin. It had 8 legs and he had a violin. It wore a collar and tie and had 100 teeth all sharp. It wore a collar, a tie and had 100 sharp teeth. It had horns and hairy ears, but the top of his head was quite bald. He had hairy ears, but his head was bald. It smiled at Sarah and Francis and barked. It looked at Sarah and Francis and then smiled and barked. A monster," cried the twins. "At last we have got a pet. Thank you, darling father." They were very happy to get a pet and they thanked their father. Mr. Delmonico had to let them keep it, of course, but he couldn't help feeling someone. He got the better of him after all. Mr. Delmonico had no choice but to allow them to keep this pet with them. Written by Margaret Mahi. So this was the story, the word wizard. Now this was the wizard who, what actually she did? Prepared a present which had the combination of everything that they thought. The head was like the lion's, hair was, ears were hairy, barked like the dogs, played violin like the, a cat. Had 8 legs because they thought at the very beginning pony each 4 legs, so 4 plus 4 equals 8. So the wizard made a combination of all the ideas that they were thinking and prepared a final monster and handed it to them. Understood? Okay, so go through the story well, and as you know, the work for your next online classes to learn the poem along with the word meanings. So here we conclude today's class. Thank you.